Hi friends, this is Ashish from developerhut.net. So welcome to Java 8 features series. So today we are going to see the first topic of Java 8 features, which is the ForEach method, which is newly implemented in Iterable interface, and we will see some of its examples and usage. So ForEach method is basically added in Iterable interface to iterate over the collection frameworks, so all the collection classes which we have. So this ForEach method is used for iterating the collections. So let's see first how we iterate the collections earlier. So let's say if I have a list, okay, which contains some elements inside it. So I have an array list, okay, which contains some elements, right? So it's an integer, it contains an integer. So how we use to iterate this? So first we will have a iterate method inside your array list, right? So let me take this, extract this iterator to local variable, right? So I have iterator now, and then later we will iterate this iterator using while loop, right? So I have while iterator, and we have a has next method which will tell us is there any next element is available in iterator or not, and if it's yes, then we will get the element. So how we'll get the element? So we will have iterator dot next method, right? So let me sys out this, and I will just say a value, okay, and I will say iterator dot next, okay. Now if you run this program, you can see the iterator will iterate and gives all the elements, right? So this is the first way of iterating over the array, okay. Now another way is to use the ForEach, right? So ForEach loop. So let me just copy this. What I will do, I will just comment this. So v01, okay, and I will keep this part as it is, and instead of iterator, using iterator, we will use a ForEach loop. Okay, so we have ForEach, okay, which is used to iterate over the arrays and list and all those things, right? So I will say sys out, and I will say again value is equal to plus integer, okay, so it will just print an integer, right? So if you run this program again, it will do the same thing. So there are two versions, okay, one with the iterator and another with the ForEach loop. Now the ForEach method, which is added in a iterable interface, we will use that one. So let me copy this, let me copy just this, okay. I will just rename this method, okay, so v2, okay, and I will say, okay, so what we will do, we will create and or initialize array in different way now. So arrays list have a method, a constructor which take a collections, okay. So I will say arrays, right, arrays dot as list, okay, and I will pass a parameter, so 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, okay. This is also one of the way where you can initialize the array. It will save a lot of, you know, lines of code, right? So it is just a single line of code. Now if you see the my list, the array list contains one method, has one method, so which is ForEach, right, which will take the consumer class, okay. So for this version we will take the anonymous class, okay, so I will say new consumer, okay, the anonymous class, as this is a generic one, consumer is a generic, and our array is a type of integer, so we will use an integer consumer, and we will override its method, okay, which is a accept method. Okay, so and here we can write our the sysout or business logic, whatever that you want. Okay, so I will say value, okay, and plus the t. So if you see, this accept method will take all the type of that particular consumer. Okay, so this forEach method will internally call the accept method and it will print all the elements or do that necessary operation. So if I run this, I will get the same output, right? So this is the forEach method which is introduced in Iterable interface. So if you go to this Iterable interface, you can see this, there is a forEach, right? So this is an Iterable interface which contains this forEach and which internally anyway calls the accept method of a consumer. Okay, so this is the third version. Now let's copy this. We will see the next one more version. So I will say I will say 3. Okay, I will just copy this. So now in this case, what we'll do, we'll just extract this consumer class. So instead of using anonymous class, we will create a separate class. Okay, so what I will do, I will create one consumer class, custom consumer class. So I will say class my consumer and which implements consumer. Okay, so consumer which is of type integer. Okay, so we have a consumer class. Let's implement the method which is accept. Okay, and it will take the parameter of type integer, and let's sysout or do whatever the operation that we want, right? Value, I will say t. Okay, and let's use this consumer. So what we will do, we will create one consumer. I will say action is equal to new consumer, right? And we will pass this my consumer reference to the forEach. Okay, so you can see the code is reduced more. Now if you run this, we'll get the same output. So internally forEach again calls the accept method. So we can also use this type of the separate class of consumer. If you see, this will make your code more structured, right? So let's see one more business case scenario where we will use this forEach. So let's say I have one user class, right, and it contains one private instance variable which is amount, right, and next is the taxable amount. Okay, now this amount contains the double value which we will get it from our database, right? However, the tax amount needs to be calculated on the basis of the amount. Okay, so for example, we will get some tax value from other table maybe, and we will add it in amount, and then we will update the tax amount, right? And then probably we will update this in the database, right? So now let's implement this. So what we will do, first we will create our user class. So I will say class, I will say user, right? And I have I will just say double private double, right, amount, right, then private double tax amount. Okay, so I have two instance variable, so let's create a getter setter. I will say select all. Getter setter is really not required, but I am adding this purposefully. I will create a constructor, so I only need amount. Okay, so tax amount anyway we will calculate during our forEach. Okay, so I have a user class ready. So let's use our same main method. Okay, so I will just rename this. It's v version 4, and instead of now the integer list, we will use the user list. Okay, and instead of my list, I will say user list. And what I will do, I will just add inside user list few users. I will add, so I will say add new user, right? And I will pass the amount 1200. Okay, and I will just copy this, and I will just add, I will update the amount with, let's say, 32 456 and 17. Okay, so I have these users. Now what I want is I have the list of users, and I wanted to calculate a tax of all these users. Okay, so what we will do, again we will use the for each, right? So user list dot for each, and let's write our consumer class. So what I will do, I will say class tax calculation consumer, okay, which will implements consumer, right? And it will take a user of type user. Okay, so let's implement the accept method, and here we will actually write our business logic, right? So I will say double tax calculated tax amount, and what I will do, I will instead of t, I will say user, and I will just add a tax amount. Let's say I will add 10 rupees of tax. Okay, plus user dot get amount, what are the business operation that you have. Okay, and I will update user dot set tax amount is calculated tax amount. Okay, so we can do this operation. So I will use a tax calculation consumer before passing it to ForEach. So I will say action is equal to new tax calculation consumer, and I will pass it to this. And later what I will do is I will just print this user. Okay, so instead of this, I will just, what I will do is I will use the for each here, and which will just sys out. I guess it should be here. So sys out, and I say user dot get tax amount of each user, right? So what we will do, we will print both. So user dot get amount plus the tax amount. Okay, so let me iterate this, and let's try to run. So you can see, so this is our initial amount, which is the actual amount which we got from the database, and this is the updated taxed amount which we have update, right? So this is how we can use the for each loop for your business related operations. So if you wanted to perform any bulk operation on a your list, so you can use the for each, and you can perform your business logic. So in my during my project development, I encountered a lot of scenarios where I get the list from the database, and I have to update those few specific specific fields of that particular object. So I mostly use this for each loop. We'll implement this consumer classes, and it is easy for me to do all those operations. Okay, so I hope you like this video. So if you have any specific question related to this for each method, you can ask your question in the comment section. If you think this video is informative, please do like this video, subscribe to this channel, and share this video. Thanks a lot.